Okay, we're going to move on to glaze preparation. Now these pots are out of the kiln and they're dusty, and quite often they have little, I guess owies is the best word for them. I was making this platter here and I was busy talking to you guys and it had a really sharp edge. So with sandpaper, I went around and I sanded them all off. I like to go along and I put them all out. I have them divided into colors. This table is one color and the smaller table is another color. I put them all out and I give them the once over. I make sure their edges are smooth. If you're using your plastic during throwing, the edges will be nice and smooth. I make sure the handles all are tidy. If there's little chunky bits, I either chip them off. You can use your fingernail or a knife. After it's all sanded and tidied, then you're ready for washing. It's important to get all the dust washed off. If you leave dust on your pieces, what will happen is the glaze will stick to the dust and not to the pot, and it'll lead to a whole myriad of glazing problems that you don't even want to know about. We're going to gently wash these guys with a sponge, and I'm not washing them like sticking them in and washing them like a dirty cup. I'm just brushing the dust off. When you were throwing this mug or anything tall, you were using a stick with a sponge on it to go in there and clean the water out. If you wash this sponge on a stick, it's a great cleaning tool. What I like to do is I get it clean, I put it in and I'll do a bunch of mugs at once. I blow any stuff out. And I like to do all the insides and the outsides. I found if you use your sponge and you stick your fingers in there and you use the big sponge, what happens is after you've done a bunch of mugs is you've rubbed all your skin off your finger and it's more than unpleasant. Well, these guys are washed and they're ready for waxing. There are two methods of waxing your pot. There's the paraffin wax. I prefer this method. This is an oil-based paraffin wax. It comes solid. You have to heat it up. We had this pan designed just for us. It sits on the two elements and it gets quite hot. Paraffin has a few pluses and a few minuses. The plus is that it is it leaves a very straight wax line. I'll show you in a minute. It's very quick, and one main perk is I prefer it. I like it, so we use this kind. But it also has a downside. It is a wax base. It is flammable. It can, if you get it too hot, burst into flames. It can really stink up a studio. If it gets on somewhere you don't want it, it is there permanently, or until you can bisque it out, but you either have to scrape all the clay away. It's very hard to correct a waxing mistake when you use the paraffin. But anyway, as I said, it is quick. This is my waxing brush. I like it just to be out of the way, but in there. Now, I like this, as I mentioned before, I'm going to wax these mugs. I'm going to put it in. If you put it in straight this way, it's going to blurp up the side and it's going to be messy. I like a very tidy wax line. I'm going to put it in gently, let the air come out, let it sit for a minute, and when you pick it up, the wax line is straight, it's tidy. I always like my pots to be tidy. You have a little bit of wax around there. You can spin it around until so it doesn't run on the pot, or you can turn it so it runs on the inside. But with these, if you go quickly, gently tip, air out, let it drip, and you can see if you have your mugs lined up, I can wax a lot of mugs very quickly. So there's waxing mugs, and the teapots would wax the same way, and the bowls and all the things just go in and they're waxed. And once I get on a roll, I can really move. Plates also work well in there. The downside about plates is it's really hard to see what you're doing because it's the downside of the plate. I'm going to look at it gently, and you can kind of see in the shadow, and you're going to let it go in. The thing I don't like about plates is if you go, oops, and now I blooped it all up, and darn, I dropped it in there. I have a terrible wax line. Now this plate, if it were part of the order, would have to go through the kiln again. It'd have to be bisque, and you can't cut all that off, and it's just, you're hooped until the next bisque. That's where the wax resist comes in. You do have a lot more control because it is brushed on. It is a water base. If I do make a mistake, I can quickly wash it off the clay and I'm not hooped until the next bisque. And the thing what I didn't mention about the paraffin is I did say it stinks up your studio when it's on, but it also really stinks up your studio when you're firing the kiln. All that paraffin on every one of these pots burns out and it really stinks. What we can do with the wax resist, as I mentioned, it is a water base. You paint it on And I used so little of this, I dated it. Dinner, dancing, movie, it was wonderful. Oh dear, I guess now Jim knows I'm. Anyway, so I'm going to just very gently put this just on a decorator's wheel, put it upside down, and you can just paint your lines that way. But I, when I was trimming it, I had kind of a dint there for wax lines. And notice I am sort of connected, my little fingers on the pot, and I'm connected to the plate I'm connected to, and I'm just very slowly turning. But you can see with a little bit of waxing practice, you're going to get a lot more plates done in the paraffin than you are with the brush. So these will, I will go ahead, I'll finish painting this one with the wax resist. The rest of the plates I'll dip in the paraffin. I'll get all the waxing done today. It'll be mostly the paraffin, a little bit of the wax resist. And by the time I get all that done, I've unloaded, I've washed, I've waxed, it'll be a day.